Hello, everybody. In today's session, we are going to talk about certain words which sound quite similar. Their pronunciation is quite similar, but there is a lot of difference in their meanings. And we hope after this session, we will have some clarity regarding the usage of these words, and we will not make any mistake in their usage. The first such set of words that we talk about are anyway versus anyways. See, both the words, they sound so similar, and the only difference between the two is that in the second word, an extra letter S is appended or it is added towards the end. So we talk about the first word, anyway. Grammatically speaking, anyway is in most of the cases used as an adverb, and it does not have one meaning. It's got multiple meanings. The first and the commonest meaning of word anyway is in any case or at least. For instance, I do not know who's the richest person in the world. He's not an Indian anyway. Means in no case, no way, this guy is an Indian. One more example I give you. He did not enjoy washing his car, but it was dirty and he did it anyway. Means in any case, he washed his car. One more example. People say his theories are true. I have not found any evidence anyway. Means no way, not in any case. I have found an evidence that his theories are true. Now, another very common usage of word anyway means nevertheless, regardless, or irrespective. The people were starving and dying. The party of the rich went on anyway. Means irrespective of the fact that whatever was the situation of the people, of the other people in the country, the elite, they continued their merrymaking and their frolicking anyway. Irrespective of anything, they continued to party. So these are the two commonest usages of word anyway, which means in any case and irrespective. Now we come to its another cousin, anyways. See, anyways, first of all, it is a word which is not commonly used in standard English. You won't find native speakers of English or even the formal publications or printed books or documents, they make use of this word. It's more of an American slang, or what we say, it is more of colloquial usage rather than a standard, formal, grammatically correct usage. And the meaning of anyways with an S is quite similar to anyway. It is also used as an adverb. And loosely, how do people use it? Anyways, it's a time for new beginning. Whatever you say, it's a dumb idea anyways. Means in any case, it's a dumb idea. And my recommendation to you is, if it is a colloquial usage, you are chatting with your friends, with your co-workers, and it's just an oral communication, you can use anyways. But please refrain it from using it in any kind of formal context, spoken or written. And now we talk about the third word of the same family, same category, anyway. But what is the difference between the third word and the first word? In the first word, on the previous slide, anyway was one word. Okay, now here, anyway, these are two separate words. And since they are two separate words, both the words, they have got different grammatical functions and entities. This is a pairing. This is a pairing of an adjective and a noun. Way. Way is a noun and any becomes adjective. So here, anyway means however possible. In any particular way, in any particular direction or whatsoever. This is what we mean by anyway. Perhaps these examples would further elaborate the meaning. Can the government help us in any way? Means in any particular way or in any particular manner. Can government aid us or assist us? Is there any way we can unravel the court? So any particular strategy, any particular mechanism by which this code can be decoded. Most people are willing to make money anyway. Right, wrong, ethical, unethical, correct, incorrect, to hell with everything. they just want to make money anyway by using any particular means or by using any particular manner. Okay, so after these set, this particular set of three words, anyway, anyways, and anyway with two different words. Now we come to the next set of very commonly used words, that is it's and its. Now you must be quite surprised, oh, it's such a simple word. Why are we even talking? Why are we even discussing about it? Yes, 100% I agree with you. It's a very, very simple and it's a very basic word. But you'd be surprised that people who are supposed to have most wonderful command over English language and even the native speakers, they make a mistake in its usage. In India, let me tell you something which is going to surprise you. Even in advertisements, in the billboards, in hoardings of advertisements, I have seen people committing a mistake of its and its. In both the cases, the word is a collection of three letters. But what's the difference between the two? In the first, it's just ITS, no apostrophe. In the second, it is IT apostrophe S. And this apostrophe, the small little comma at the top, that's an absolute game changer. And it totally changes the meaning of the word. The funny part is both the words, they have got exactly the same pronunciation. It's both these words, they are derived from the same base word or the same base pronoun, it. Okay, first we talk about the first word, ITS. Now here, what is it's? It means it's a possessive pronoun, like word his or hers. So similarly, it's is also a possessive pronoun. For instance, I have a pet at home. Its tail is black. Now here it shows the position of the tail by your pet. So that is why usage is just ITS. A very simple proverb, a very common proverb. Don't judge a book by its cover. Now it refers to cover and the position of the cover by the book. So that is why we use here ITS with no apostrophe. Now we talk about the second usage, which is IT apostrophe S. It's, now what is it's? It's a contraction. It's a contraction which combines the two words, it is. And the simplest example I can give you here is, look at the example given on the screen. It is a hot and a sunny day. Correct. It's a hot and sunny day. So it's a contraction which combines two separate words. And please notice finally, there's a slight difference in pronunciation as well. It, how do we pronounce, how do we say the first sentence? It is a hot and a sunny day. It is a. So all the three words, they're very clear. In the second, well, how do we say the sentence? It's, it is, and it's. So the when we combine, we pronounce them quickly, crisply. It's a hot and sunny day. So I hope that you've got some clarity over the difference in usage of the two words, it's and its. So now, let us check our understanding of these two very simple words, it's and its. Okay. In all these four questions or in all the four sentences, the first one, ITS, is option A. And IT apostrophe S is option B. So when you think of an answer, please think in terms of A and B. Let's look at the first sentence. Dash, it's wonderful when an artist gets a standing ovation. So what do you think will come here? Dash, wonderful when an artist gets a standing ovation. It's, yes, you are right. The right option here is option B. It is wonderful. So the right option would be B, where we use it's with a apostrophe or as a contraction. Okay, let's move on to the second sentence. Every play I read has its unique and original plot. It's unique and original plot. So which is the right option? Yes, the right option is option A, because here it refers to the plot and possession of the plot by the play. So here the right option would be option A. It's got to be true. Yeah, very easy. Bingo, you're right on there. Right option is option B. It's got to be true, the one with an apostrophe. Okay, fourth one, I find it to be a very interesting proverb. What are proverbs? These are the statements which are packed with practical wisdom. A very interesting statement. I hope you too enjoy it. A lie travels halfway around the world before the truth has a chance to get its pants on. So here it will be what? Option A or option B? Think before the truth has a chance to get its pants on. Yes, you are right. It's option A. Why? Because it shows or it refers to what? It refers to the pants which are possessed by the truth. So it shows a case of possession. So the right option here is option A. So for all the four sentences, what is the answer key? B, A, B, A. Okay, so I hope you have enjoyed this session and we have learned the finer differences between similar sounding words. And now we will use them correctly and with much more clarity, leaving little or no room for any sorts of confusion or ambiguity. So it was wonderful preparing this small little session for you. I hope you enjoyed it. There was some wealth of learning. Thank you and happy learning.